This is the Yojimbo 2. This is a design that I came up with that is essentially the next generation of my original Spyderco folding knife design, the Yojimbo. Yojimbo means bodyguard in Japanese. And this is basically an expression of what I consider to be an ideal personal defense knife that also has great utility knife application. Primary thing is it's a Warncliffe blade design. With a Warncliffe, you have a straight cutting edge, and what it allows you to do is to pack as much cutting power into as small a blade as possible. In this case, we have a 3 1/4 inch blade, and what it allows you to do when you're gripping the knife, if you're cutting, you're cutting with full power all the way to the tip. There's no point where the cutting edge curves away, so that if the arc of motion of your arm and that cutting edge coincide, that you're no longer applying pressure into the target. So what you want is something that's going to cut with full power all the way to the tip. From a utility standpoint, that also allows you to cut with great power at the tip. So just like a typical utility knife, it gives you that same type of function. Unlike the original Yojimbo, this is a hollow ground blade, so it's a partial hollow grind. What that does is it maintains a lot of thickness in the spine of the blade here, and that retains a lot of mass in the blade as well, but it still gives you excellent edge geometry, and it also reinforces the point. So you have very thick steel all the way up to here, and then this tapers down to the point, so it gives you a stronger point than the original full flat grind. Notice there's no jimping on the back of the blade here. There is a little bit of texturing here, so if you like a saber grip or something like that, you do have a purchase for the thumb. But what I really prefer is the idea of extending the thumb all the way forward. So you notice the contour here fits very nicely with the thumb. What that allows you to do is to use the thumb as a guide to make the knife a natural extension of the hand. So especially if I'm cutting ballistically, anything that I aim my thumb at, I'm automatically going to engage at the heel of the blade and then cut through with full power all the way to the tip. By not having jimping here, I have nothing that is going to create any abrasion on my thumb, so if I have a hard impact or something of that nature. Also, in the closed position, when this is drawn from the pocket, there's nothing here that's going to abrade the clothing and wear out my pockets any quicker. This is a compression lock mechanism, and compared to the original Yojimbo, this is improved not only because we have made great strides in perfecting the compression lock, but primarily because it also has a ball bearing detent. So you have a strong self-close mechanism that keeps the blade closed. There's no way that it's going to open it inadvertently, but it can still be deployed very, very quickly. With the compression lock, one of the great benefits of that is when I go to close the blade, simply apply pressure here, and I can close it without ever having to get my thumb in the way of the cutting edge. Unlike a liner lock where I'd have to release the lock and close it this way, very easy to close one-handed without ever getting my hand in the way of the edge. Notice that all the screws and hardware are all flush. What that allows you to do is to have a four-position clip, so it's set up for tip up, tip down, left or right side carry. So whatever your carry preference might be, it'll support all of those. This is a nested construction, so what you have are nested liners that are actually set into the machined G10 handles. So what that gives you is a thinner overall profile, but still great strength, and it also gives you a very strong attachment point for the clip no matter where it is it's attached. So this is actually a pilot run of the Yojimbo 2. This is actually made from the engineering drawings, so this is very close to what we anticipate for production on the Yojimbo 2, and right now we're anticipating production will be on the shelf sometime toward the end of 2011.